Hello guys, what is up? It is Finn here bringing you guys some more NHL 16 Be a GM with our Philadelphia Flyers, and we are playing the first possible elimination game. And before we start this episode, let's see if we can hit 20 likes on this episode. So go ahead, show your love and support, hit that like button. You guys have been doing a phenomenal job. And we are 2-3 in the playoffs. I will show you guys what's been going on. We lost the first two, then we won the next two, and then we lost the next one in overtime. We were also on a killing a penalty when we lost, but it was a very it was a sad loss. It really was. But I don't want this season to end. I really don't. I want to win these next two games. I really want to take this to the Stanley Cup. If we lose in the Stanley Cup, you know, okay. But I really want to make it to the Stanley Cup at least. So, and I know this is a team that can do so. I have started Mason again. He has been doing well, actually, except for that one game. Neuwirth has been doing decent, too. But I want to start Mason and see how he does again. You guys will see his stats. But this is going to be... I don't want to lose. I really don't. Why does it say style custom? That's not what I want. That's weird. Okay, hardcore. I don't know what custom is. Maybe I changed something by accident. But let me just make sure I have the right goalie starting. No, you don't go there. You have to go to edit lines. And since this is a playoff game, I figure why not show the stats, the goalie, so I'm not going to show him here. But, all right, here we go. Start game. But I really do want to win this one. I really do. I'm hoping for the best and hoping to take it to a game seven so we can win it back at Philly. But we have to see. We really have to see. But I mean, they've been very low scoring games except for the one. I think there was one. I don't know if there was one. No, I don't think there really was. They've been pretty low scoring, like mostly three goals is the one that wins the game. So most goalies have been doing pretty well. Schneider's been very hard to score against. I mean, you can't get a one-timer on that guy, and usually if you do, he like just misses it. So you have to pass it really fast to get that one-time goal, but I'm hoping to get... We have to get a lot of one-timers this game because you just can't get basic shots past this guy. At least I can't figure it out. But you have to do a lot of behind the net one timers. So I mean, look at those stats. I mean, the save percentage isn't as good as you'd think, but he's doing pretty well. I mean, he's really hard to stop. The only reason why we score against some one timers, most basic shots don't get past this guy. So I mean, he's really hard to score against. But Mason, I mean, look at those stats. He's been doing very well. 2-1-1. 1.91 goals against, 0.926 save percentage, and he has a shutout. So he's been doing very phenomenal this playoff. So even if we lose this game, I'd still consider it a win for him, unless he does horrible this game. But hopefully we can win this one and take it back to Philly. All right, here we go. Don't turn it over yet. Here we go. One time already. Oh. Thought we could get it to Simmons for the one-time goal. Here we go. Voracek. Oh, come on, Simmons. Here we go. Get that through. Oh, I tried. One straight. Misses the check. It's already poked it away. McDonald. Come on. Stop the play. There we go. Up to Giroux. Here we go. Giroux and Simmons. Oh, my God. I can't saucer pass it at all. Oh, come on, Giroux. How do you miss that? You're a 90 overall. You can't get a basic pass. I don't know who has the most points, though, in the playoffs. I'm going to say it's either Voracek or McDonald. Nice save by Mason. Lecavalier hasn't been doing so hot. Actually, wait, maybe he has. Hartnell, I don't think, has a goal yet. Or maybe he does. I don't know. I'm having a hard time keeping track. Come on, get that to Couturier. I took a risk. I knew it wasn't going to go through, but you never know. But I'm loving the postseason. I don't want to lose at all. It seems too early for us to go. I feel like we are going to win it here. I don't know about the Stanley Cup, if that's going to happen. Like, if we're going to win it, but I feel like we're going to go far in the playoffs. Oh, no. Not if we do stupid stuff like that. Oh, nice save by Mason. Yeah, usually they don't do too good, the computers, on the breakaway. Come on, get it to Reed. Oh, man, that should have been a goal. Nice hit.
Puck gathered in behind the net by Shen.
Up to Hag.
Wrist shot.
Come on, Shen, stay with that. Reed. Oh, and he turns it over right away. Nice Reed.
In the slot, he's got it.
Nice try. Over to Shen, nice! Oh man, see? It's the one-timers. That's what you have to do to score against this guy. I don't know how that got through, though. I mean, I don't blame him for that. You have to blame the defense. Braden Shen. Look at that. I don't know how that got through. The fact that went in was just awesome. All right. Look at that. 1-0 lead already to start this game off. And in case you guys were not aware, if we do win this game, the next episode will be recorded because, see, like, he probably wouldn't have scored because Schneider got over there very quickly. One Hag, nice hit. He has been doing very well with the hits in the playoffs. Come on, Gagne, over to Lawton, nice. Lawton has been doing phenomenal, too, in the playoffs. Look at that. Oh, they just all turned around. They all wanted a hug, and then they saw they didn't get it, so they just turned around. Hag and Gagne with the assists. And even there, he almost had that, but nope, 2-0. I'm not getting my hopes up, though, because the last game we recorded, we got two early goals, and then we lost. So hopefully we can keep them scoreless at least this period. The whole game would be nice, but here we go. Up to Gagne. Ooh. I don't have anything. Oh, nice save. You see what I mean? Like, he can still stop stuff. This guy has been very hard to score against. I'm surprised we got two goals already. I was hoping he wouldn't pass that out. Luckily, he didn't. All right, here we go. Shen hasn't been doing too well in the face-offs. My point exactly.
Back in his defensive end to get
it. Nice hit by Manning. Oh, never mind. I was going to give it to Shen, but he just skated away.
Gets on by.
Here we go. Up to Reed.
Philadelphia's moving the puck through center ice.
Nice shot.
And still with it in their own end. On
I was hoping I could block the pass.
Many yards gained to close. Pass to the slot.
Oh no. I'm not liking this. There we go. I'll take that. Freeze it. My teammates are on top of him. Alright, here we go. Let's win this face off and get this out of the zone. Try and get one more scoring chance before this period's over. Dvorak. Ah, come on.
Laid on to Larson. To Jelen. Pitching this one to Tutu.
Hit him. Ah, come on. Strike can't hit at all. And I thought that was going to happen. Kind of McDonald's fault, though, that he couldn't get that.
First period, still with lots of time. Let's see if they can tie.
All right, come on, McDonald. You got to redeem yourself after that. All right, 2-1. So we still need some insurance here. Oh, that sucks. Off a skate. And Raffle gets the goal. Oh, that sucks. That sucks. Look at this. I was going for the one-timer to Hartnell. And it's off his skate. Larson's skate. I mean, if Hartnell got that pass, we probably would have scored, but still, that sucks so much for them. Ooh, wow, that got through. Can he stay with it, though? Ooh. And no one's there. Of course not. Come on, Shen. Nice hit. Look at this. 3-1 already. Oh, wow. I'm surprised that got through. Lawton. 4 goals in the first period. Schneider is not looking hot. I wish we'd been playing like this throughout the playoffs. Jeez. I'm surprised that actually worked, but he went for the poke check and missed. Wow. Okay. 4-1. Well, I think we have this game in the bag. I don't see Mason giving up 3 more goals. I mean, it could happen, but I'm hoping it won't. Easy game. I mean, I'm still going to go for some more goals, but let me actually play a little bit more conservative. Because we don't want, I mean, we want to score more if we can, but that's not high on our priority list. I'd rather play defensive.
The Devils from the neutral zone start to work. Mashed in. Cranks a shot.
Nice hit.
And he's held up against the boards. Forcing attention in deep. On through the...
Come on. Nice block by McDonald.
Oh, the pass wouldn't go.
Snapping to Simmons.
Good jab with the...
Running out of time here. Over to Voracek. Come on. Put it in. Bury it. Ah. Thought Simmons would get that rebound. Give it to Strait. Strait, however you say his name. Over to Simmons. Come on, before the period's over. And that's the end. 5 goals in one period. 4 for us, 1 for them. Very high scoring period, at least on one side, and that would be us. I'm surprised with how well we did. I mean, that's like the most goals we've scored in a game, I think. All playoffs. I don't know if we've scored more than 4 goals, and Lawton's got 2. Maybe we can get him a hat trick. That'd be nice. But only 11 shots for us, 4 for them. Neither save percentage-wise, but I mean, I'm okay with Mason only getting 4 shots this game. I really don't want to give him any more, but you know what? It looks like this game is going to a Game 7 back at home. And hopefully we can play well. I thought I could fool him with the backhand, but it didn't get through. So we'll never know if it would have went in. Uh-oh. Pass that out. Voracek now.
And they've got a 3-on-2 here.
Nice shot, and he's going to freeze up. All right. Here we go. So if you guys want to, always feel free to leave your comments on like what you guys think I should do this offseason or what you guys would like to see. I don't know who's a free agent. Oh, I thought that was going to get in. Here we go, here we go. Oh, man, I was trying to get it to Couturier. Lawton, though, has just been phenomenal. I kind of would like to see him win the award. I kind of want to call him up, but I just love my fourth line so much. I kind of want to keep him on the fourth line because I just... They're actually a really good line. Aw, come on. But no, feel free to leave your comments towards, like, who you would like to see, like, what moves you want to see, who you don't want to see on the team anymore, who you do think should get re-signed, who I should sign. I don't know who's a free agent, though. As of now, my focus is offense. I don't have any guys offensively that I plan on calling up. If anyone, it would probably be Lair. I think that's how you say his name. Tyler Lair. But, I mean, he's the only guy, but I don't think he's ready yet, unfortunately. But Ghost is definitely going to be up next season. I don't know what who we're going to lose. It might be McDonald. It might be Strike. I don't know. If he starts diminishing, like, overall-wise, Strike, then I'm going to have to get rid of him. I don't want to. I do like him, but, I mean, he's going to have to go. And as for guys like, who else do we have in the minors? Stolarz, you're definitely going to see him in the preseason. I do plan on recording at least one preseason game just to show you guys, or at least, you know, maybe a collaboration of games from the preseason just to show you guys some highlights of what's going on. But you're still going to see some of these guys. Some of them won't be playing as much. But I don't know how you can do the postseason. I think you can just call everyone up, or at least as many guys as you want. I think that's how they usually do it. But come on, Voracek, give him a good hit. Ah. But guys I eventually want to see are Stolarz. I don't know if he'll be ready though next season. I think he's only a 72 overall. I do have him starting though because he's been doing very well, and I have Michael Leighton as the backup goaltender. But I think his stats are starting to go down as well. So a goal given up by Mason. But here we go. The fourth line's out now. Watch out. They've been very good this in the playoffs. Over to Lawton. I tried to get it to him. It didn't work. Oh man, McDonald can't hit that well, can he? I thought that was going to be a big hit. Oh, come on, Gagne. Pick that up. Gagne, I don't know what the deal's going to be with him, because he's that one guy on the team that you just can't make happy. I don't know what his deal is, but he just won't be happy. I tried putting him on the trade block because I was like, maybe he just doesn't want to play on the team anymore. And then that made him even more unhappy. So I took him off, and he was happy. If he was unhappy for me taking him off, then I would have just released him and not cared anymore. But, I mean, his stats were going down because I think it was because he wasn't playing because I had him scratched. But I was like, all right, I'll play him. And he's been doing pretty well, so I don't know what he has to be upset about. It's like he'll have a game where he gets, like, a goal and an assist, and he'll be like, he's unhappy with his recent performance. And I'm like, why? He's doing pretty well. I mean, you're on the fourth line. I'm not going to send you up to the third yet. But I might in the future. You know, I don't know what the deal is going to be yet. LeCavalier, I don't know if I'm going to have him next year. I like him a lot. Oh, here's a goal. Ah, speaking of LeCavalier. But, and then there's guys like, who else do we have? Hartnell, I do want to see him back. I think he's only 33. Oh, come on. I had that in. Why is he shooting? And I thought that was going to get deflected. And then, who else do we have? I'm trying to think of guys. The whole first line I plan on having back. I don't want to get rid of Simmons. I don't want to get rid of Giroux. I don't want to get rid of Voracek. If any of those guys were to go, it would probably be Simmons. But none of them are leaving, no matter what. And then who else do we have? Let me think of the second line. We have Hartnell, Couturier, and Raffle. I don't plan on getting rid of any of those guys either. The only way that I'm going to get rid of guys is age, salary, or their overall is just going down because they're getting older. But if their overall is going up or just not doing much, then I'll keep them, you know, if they're worth it, such as Strite, and because he's the oldest on the team, and who else is old? LeCavalier. Hartnell's getting there, but he shouldn't be diminishing yet. Who else is there? Couturier, I plan on keeping. Hartnell, I want to keep for sure. Nice job there on the rebound by Mason. Who else is there? There's one guy. Raffle. So yeah, those guys I plan on keeping. As for the third line, we have Lecavalier. Oh, come on. Who else is there? Lecavalier, Shen, and Reed. Reed, I'm not so sure about. I do like him, but he just doesn't perform that well. That should have been a goal if that got through. But good defense there. And then who else is there? There is, I'm trying to think of who else. That is the whole third line. And then the fourth line, I don't want to get rid of anyone there. Ryan White, Lawton, I actually would like to see him on the third line. But with guys like Shen and Couturier, if anything, actually someone left a comment saying this. And I was like, that might be a good idea. But just with the guys I have already, I kind of don't want to do that. But someone actually said to move Shen to wing. And I actually do agree with that because Shen is just absolutely brutal with face-offs. And, you know, I was like, actually, I might do that. I might decide to do that. So that is possible. I might do that in the preseason, see how that works, and call up Lawton to the third line. I eventually would like to see him on the second, but with Couturier, it's just going to be tough. But, who else is there? Defensively, Streit and McDonald, I'm not sure. Don't be surprised if neither of them are on the team next season. Because McDonald, it's just, I really want to start progressing guys. But McDonald is a high overall. I think he's like an 85, 86. And then Streit, if nothing happens with Streit, well, I still could get rid of him if he has high trade value. Even though, because he's older, I might try and get, you know, draft picks for him or something like that. So I might throw him on the trade block next season. If his overall isn't diminishing, because you guys gotta admit that he would be, that should have been a goal. I think that hit the post. I couldn't hear it because I don't have my volume up, but yeah, so Streit, I could get rid of. He's a great, defensive player, but it's just with age, and if I could get someone good for him, I do want to get rid of him. You know, because there's, you know, plenty of D-men I want to start progressing, like, Ghost, Morin. I don't think he's ready yet, though, but, and, also, I think there might be another D-man. Manning is, you know, a guy, but, as of now, everyone you see defensively except for Streit and McDonald will probably be on the team. So, Shen, I still plan to have, who else is there? Hag, for sure. Manning, definitely. And who else? Who's the other defenseman on our team? I can't remember who it is. Oh, come on. Can he get through? He's not going to. Oh, wait. Yeah, there was no deke I could have done there. Oh, here we go. Oh, Hartnell. Oh, he still got. No, never mind. He lost it. Who's the other D-man? Now this is going to. Oh, Delzato. There he is. Yeah, I still plan on having Delzato. He's actually going up. His morale is starting to progress. So I do plan to keep him. And that's pretty much it. But, of course, if you guys do want me to, you know, if you guys do have any recommendations, I can't guarantee it's going to happen. But I do plan on doing one episode where it's just all off-season stuff. Oh, man, off the post. But, I am going to do one season where we do the draft, where we do, you know, free agent signing. So it'll probably be a long episode. It could be even an hour. I don't know how long it'll take. But I'm probably going to end up drafting a forward. That is my guess. I thought about a goalie, but I was like, you know, with Stolarz, and, you know, you can always sign decent backups. And I think we're good with Neuwirth and Mason for a good more, a couple more years, but maybe I will draft a goalie, you know, second or third, but as of now, a forward is, you know, really high on my priority list, so our forwards are getting older with, Lecavalier, Hartnell, and who else is there, Drew is, I mean, he's only 28, but, you know, I don't know how much longer he's going to be a 90 for, probably a couple more years. But, and who else is there? There's, Lecavalier, Hartnell, and, just in case, you know, guys get hurt, you know, I need to start progressing and trading guys. Eventually, some of these guys might get traded away. And, you know, and like Raffle or Raffle Reed, you know, they're not, you know, some, they're kind of young. I think they're like 28, 29. I think Raffle's either 27 or 28, but you know, they're not high overalls. They're only 82, 83. But, so that's like why I could get rid of them, because if I can get a better prospect, I eventually want to use him. Oh, I totally forgot about, the one guy that's still in the CHL, but I think next year, because in Be a Pro, when I was playing the Flyers, I saw him on the team. Provorov is a guy that I would expect to see maybe next season. I don't know how good he's going to be. He'll probably be playing preseason with us. But other than that, I do expect to call him up, because I think he's like a 70... I don't know exactly what he is. I think he's like a 71 at the moment, but he's got high potential. I think the guy's only 19 or, you know, 20. He's something like that. He's very young. He's still playing in the CHL, though. So, but yeah, expect to see him as well. So, we got a lot of defense, you know, a lot of things to decide with our defensemen, like Streit, McDonald. So both of them expect to see traded. You know, I could always try and trade for a pick and see what I can do there, because I would love to get, you know, someone decent in the early rounds, since, you know, we're obviously not going to with how good we've been doing this season. I think it's, I don't know if they pick based on playoffs, or if it's based on regular season, then we're going to definitely get, you know, the last pick. But if it's based on playoffs as well, I don't know. So, I'm not sure. But either or, I don't expect to get, you know, the best guy in the draft, or, you know, one of the best guys in the draft. So, I'm not sure what we're going to be doing. In the beginning of the season, it was my mistake to assign the scout to get a defenseman. Oh, that was a good opportunity. Good save by Schneider. But that was my mistake. I shouldn't have gotten him to a scout defenseman. But now I have him going after... Oh, what? How did... Hold on. How did that not go in? That happened so quick. Like, that save. Like, you would think right here, it's a sure goal. That's not fair. His leg kicked so fast. Oh, well. But, anyway... So yeah, I really don't know what the deal's going to be with our defensemen, like Streit and McDonald. I know I've already said that like 10 times, though. But it's true, I do want to trade them, thinking about it. And now, you know, I did say earlier that I would keep Streit and McDonald if they're, or at least Streit. I did say I would keep him if his overall didn't seem like it was starting to diminish. But, because the guy is 38 years old. But, you know, if he still has decent trade value, you know, I'll probably trade him. Or if he doesn't, I'll probably keep him just to have that, you know, that decent, you know, or that good overall on my team. Because he is the best defenseman on the team, and getting rid of him would make it McDonald. But I think with Hag and Manning and Provorov and Ghost, we're going to have good defensemen. So that's why drafting a defenseman is not really, you know, something I really think we need. But I do think we need some more players, but I think we need to get rid of some guys too. Oh, we have an empty net. Who's going to get it? LeCavulier? Maybe? Oh, is that in? It's in. There we go. LeCavulier with the empty net goal. 5-2. Well, I think we are going to be taking this to a Game 7 unless they score 3 goals in 45 seconds, which I don't think is going to happen. Let me just see how many shots they have. 20 shots, okay. I didn't even think they had that many, because in the beginning of the game, they only had 4 in the first period. But, I really hope you guys have enjoyed this episode, and I just wanted to let you guys know what's going to be happening for the offseason. So there's going to be an offseason episode. Where we do the trades, if we do any. Free agent signings, re-signing players, and, of course, the draft. So, I'm looking forward to it, and I hope you guys are as... Aww, Mason, come on. There goes that decent game for him. Might as well just play to defend the lead for the last couple seconds. Since I really don't need any more goals. I kind of wanted him to get some more shots, Mason, but, you know, not going to risk giving up another goal. Just put that in the zone. It doesn't matter at this point. Oh, they're pulling again. Just freeze it. There we go. Well, that is going to do it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed, and we are going to be playing a Game 7 in Philly. And don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and hopefully we can pull the next game, or a win from the next game. And I will see you guys in that episode. Peace.